Hi everyone, my name is Hayati. I'm part of the I'm Inspired team here at Exposure. We're interviewing Chief Helen Millichap, who is the Borough Commander in Haringey, about careers in the police force.
My job title, quite complicated, I'm afraid. I'm a Chief Superintendent, but my actual role is Borough Commander for Haringey Police. And what inspired me to become a police officer? It's not something I wanted to do from a really early age. Some kids know that they want to be police officers right from when they're small. But I must admit, it came to me as an idea for a job quite late on. I was an undergraduate studying history, and in my final year, I was wondering what to do for a career. And I happened to come across an opportunity to do some work experience with West Yorkshire Police. I fell in love with the idea of doing it for a job myself. I saw this police officer do such amazing things single-handedly. He was single crewed on one shift. He arrested a burglar, comforted a victim of crime, talked to some kids on the street, did some paperwork. And I just think the range of things that he did just in an ordinary day as a police officer filled me with awe, actually. I thought I would really love to be him one day and to be able to do all of that. The skills that you need as a police officer are things like effective communication, good people skills, and our values. So integrity, compassion, professionalism, and courage. And you can't really measure those things by exams or qualifications or background. You know, those things you find in every walk of life, in every type of person. As you probably know, women only joined the police around 100 years ago. And even then, they joined effectively a separate police force that had different conditions and worked in different ways than male officers. For example, doing typically female jobs as they were back then, like child protection and dealing with women. They even had a smaller police truncheon that fitted in a police handbag, which was totally different to what male colleagues had. And actually, even the first female uniform was designed by Harrods, which I'm afraid does not happen anymore. So being a female police officer started off as a very different thing. Nowadays, we have total equality. There aren't any police jobs that females can't do. So one of the great things about doing this job is we have the unique privilege of being in the middle of life as it is in this wonderful city. And sometimes that's really hard, because often when people call us, it's in their time of greatest need. Yeah. It can be because of a situation that's the worst thing that's happened to them, if they're a victim of crime in their lives, potentially. Getting the balance right between recognising my job is to defend and to support my staff, but also recognising that we are here to learn. We don't always get it right. We make mistakes. And we need to be open to criticism and be willing to listen to it properly, rather than listening to it but not really doing anything about it. Robert Peel said famously, "The police are the public and the public are the police." And while that sounds like a bit of a riddle, it's not really. It means that police officers are also a member of the public. Yeah. They're not always in a uniform and doing their job. They're also sons, daughters, mothers, fathers, sisters, brothers, friends, neighbours. And actually, the public are also the police, because, you know, we police by consent. Hopefully we have a mandate from the public to do what we do. You might be surprised how many different jobs there are within our organisation. We're huge, 32,000 police officers roughly, and not all of those are frontline uniform officers who people will see out and about. Probably that's what most people think a police officer does. But actually, there are very many detectives who work very carefully, methodically and thoroughly in the background, often in plain clothes, solving cases, cracking cases, taking really complex investigations to court. There are some of the more fantastically brilliant jobs, like I suppose being a dog handler, or, you know, a horse rider or a helicopter pilot. You know, there's all sorts of things, really interesting bits of our job that might not be obvious to those looking in. One of the other great things about our job is there are some specialist support services who may not be warranted police officers, but are very much part of how we work. It's the CSI type people. So the advice I would give is, be curious, be open-minded, ask lots of questions. You will have, if you're a Londoner, a local police officer who works near you, and you will be able to go on our website and find out who they are. Just get in touch, have a chat. That's what I'd suggest.